again, and time flies when you're having fun. It feels like you were just here like yesterday, but you are back, and it's always happy to see your beautiful face. The lovely and talented and busy Whitney Reynolds is here.
Well, running. I am so excited to be back with this month's Whitney's Woman. We have an amazing gal named Karen and her husband. See, I always say we don't discriminate against the men. So we also have Alan here as well. Welcome, guys.
We're a team.
And girls. Yeah, team. Whitney's team women today. Yes. Yeah, so tell us about your nonprofit.
Midwest Young Artists Conservatory is a youth music program. We serve kids that are preschool through high school, and we are located in the community of Fort Sheridan, but we draw students from all 74 different communities all through the Northwest, from probably Madison, Wisconsin, to Kankakee, Illinois, and
Rockford,
all wow. over the place.
Literally all of Chicagoland and some. Yes. You know, I'm sorry, I'm going to go off on a small tangent, but you know, I love when I meet people and they say, I'm from Chicago, and I'm like, where? And they're like, Rockford. But you're literally pulling all of Chicagoland. I mean, we love everyone here, right. But that's awesome. So everyone listening can be a part of this.
Right, and we like to think we provide the motivation for kids to practice when they're and bring passionate kids together. And in youth music ensembles. And
that's
Alan,
our
you
focus.
Can tell them we have nine.
Well, yeah. And I was going to say, Alan, tell us about what exactly that is. Because, you know, we've hit this time where we know, like, some of our country and our rap. But what is a music ensemble?
Well, a music ensemble, in our case, is one of nine orchestras, 60-plus chamber music groups. Chamber music groups like being string quartet, mm-hmm. woodwind quintet, brass quintet, percussion ensemble, harp ensemble. We have four jazz bands, six jazz combos, three choirs, and then early music opportunities for children.
Music
and movements classes, correct? Mm. And we don't do any private teaching ourselves. That's what a lot of music programs provide, but we instead provide the opportunity for them to get together, to have a social event, and to realize. I'll never forget one of the kids that came to me, a strapping, handsome kid from out in the way out. I won't tell you the name of the city, so they don't feel bad. And I said, well, what do your kids think about you playing flute? He said, oh, I wouldn't dare tell them that.
Oh.
He said, the only place I can do that is here.
Oh, wow,
so
that is beautiful.
We provide a community
yeah.
for them to realize that they're not really different than other kids.
Well, and that's what I personally listen to all types of music. I love classical. I love the orchestras. I mean,
jazz.
I love, after 5 p.m. at my house, you'll hear jazz. And so with that, I think that almost could be a lost art if we didn't get these kids together.
Darn tootin'
it is. And there is some brain effect. I know I've seen studies where if
Absolutely.
You listen to this type of stuff, it helps your schooling, right?
Right. And we find our students, a lot of our students are very good at math.
Oh, really? Okay.
And music. And
so engineering. A lot of students graduate in engineering.
Well, and you guys are filling this gap for the summer because there's a lot of summer programs out there and you have summer camps going on. You also have a big concert coming up in August. Tell us about that.
We have a cool concert. There's two, actually, concerts. One of them is in Cantigny, the mm-hmm. park out in Wheaton.
Okay.
And that's on, help me.
It is on August 17th.
August
17th.
It's 6 o'clock and it's all pops music mm-hmm. played by the orchestra. And then the very next afternoon at 3 o'clock at our place in Fort Sheridan, we do the same program again. And so we like to do all different kinds of music, and that program will be really fun. We used to, until this year, last 10 years, we worked with the Lang Lang Foundation. Lang Lang is a famous pianist, and we did concerts with students. He brought students from all over the world here. We had 9 to 15 students here who would stay with our families from Germany, from China, from all over the world, and we would play a concert with them.
In Millennium Park.
Oh, wow. In Millennium Park.
Yeah, and this year we decided to take a 1 year off to let them reorganize. They're restructuring their organization. So we're doing pops concerts instead.
Oh, that sounds so exciting. Where can people get tickets to this?
They're free.
They're free. And where can people find out more about the organization?
On our website, mya.org.
MYA.org. And let's just talk about the nonprofit side of this music program. Tuition, what the kids pay, does not even cover the full cost of what it costs to run it.
It covers about 56%.
Jeez.
Earned income goes up to about, well, that includes ticket sales and program ads, pulls it up to around 62%. So we fundraise the rest, which is why we're a nonprofit.
That's amazing. And so you're giving these kids this opportunity to really learn about the arts and music.
One of the things that's important is that we don't discriminate. When they audition, we don't care if they have the ability to pay. So we have a financial aid process they can go through. And if, and so we help kids who come from underserved communities who can't afford maybe to come. We help them with scholarships. We also provide various events like master classes and performance classes. And the places we play that are spectacular. Millennium Park, Ravinia we play in every year. We play in Symphony Center often. We play in Pick Stager Concert Hall. And those are special places where the kids are inspired, hopefully, to take it seriously.
Yeah.
And to do, and we're not trying to graduate musicians, because we always say our tagline is, it's more than the music. It's teaching them how to be good citizens, teaching them to work hard, and the value of putting 100% into everything they do.
Oh, I love that. Now, Brady, you probably practice. Like, to get into radio, you probably practice.
Yeah, I just want to say, I mean, we are sitting here in a radio station studio, so thank you on behalf of all of us radio workers. We need the new music and the new artists to continue to grow, so I appreciate what you're doing. And, you know, one of, obviously, music is my passion, and one of my mottos is, you know, without music, life would be a mistake. And I think you guys kind of fill that void where a lot of programs, a lot of schools cut funding. Number one thing to go is music. Yeah. You know, instruments are gone.
Very interesting. You know, the movement in education called STEM, which is science, math,
technology, engineering, and math.
And then that didn't include arts. Mm-hmm. And I see that in the number. When that hit, that became very popular about 5-6 years ago, and then it, we finally got the arts back in.
We need to call
and
it STEM.
I see it in the, now it's STEAM.
Oh, it is a thing. That's even better.
It felt so organic.
I feel like we're in a sauna right now.
And I can see the number of kids that are in our programs for those years where there was a focus on STEM rather than STEAM being way smaller and being way less kids involved in music and involved in having doing something. There's a lot of ugly things in our world. And one of the things we all should be focusing on is the beautiful things. And that's what we provide for them as an oral. You know, beautifully, it's in our building where we work is really beautiful. We try to keep it up and try to have them realize that the quality of life is way more important than just whatever they do.
Right.
And that they should be respecting others and respecting life. And
Well, and I love what you said about practicing, because I want to go back to that, because I feel like as a kid, whenever I took piano, practicing was one of those things that I really didn't want to do, but it taught me so many life skills along the way of like getting better at something, even when you're not good. It's like learning that work and putting in the time, and I think that's a gift in itself to give those kids, and you know, just like the whole hard work does pay off concept, they're seeing that firsthand.
It's the discipline that it takes every day to practice. And like I said, the motivation, if they come together with other kids, there's a reason, because they want to fit in and know their parts and then just create that beautiful music.
That is so wonderful. Again, tell people where they can find out more about you.
MYA.org.
Well, thank you so much for coming on.
You want to start a band, Whitney?
I can't
piano. There you go.
And I sing.
Hey, I was in Mr. Buzzle's choir chorus class circa 19.
You could be Brittany, like Whitney, or Whitney and Brady. Brittany. Like a new Brittany.
I don't think that name's taken by any musician, so let's go with Brittany. Okay.
Like the original, 2019 Britney.
That's right.
Awesome. Name here.
Yeah, right here.
Man. So what else do you have coming up, Whitney? Well, I know you're busy.
We actually have a live taping in the books this fall, so I'm so excited to release some tickets on that. We also picked up a new market.
What?
I know. Where's the... we are announcing that the first week of July, so stay tuned for that. You know, with the Whitney Reynolds Show, our mission is to provoke positive change through media, and it takes stations coming alongside us to push that forward. Mm-hmm. So we love our home base of Chicago. Because it's so firm and strong, we are able to grow. So people can always find out more about the Whitney Reynolds Show on WhitneyReynolds.com or on social. And I'm going to be here next month, so we'll be bringing other fabulous women in for Whitney's Women.
Love it. Can't wait. Thanks, Whitney.
Thank you.
For more information, check out WhitneyReynolds.com or get social with us, Twitter @WhitneyReynolds or on Facebook, The Whitney Reynolds Show.